transportation of my town. So I have a big kiln, and I use that by making really large pieces, but I fire a small kiln fairly often, and I find that to be much more satisfying than waiting to fire the big kiln and having to make a lot. I also feel like I need to check on myself fairly often. If I haven't worked for a little while, I need to do a couple pieces and see them, and then think, oh yeah, that was a bad idea, I shouldn't do that again. So fortunately, now they're making kilns in a lot of sizes. I just had to replace one of my old kilns that was pretty rusted out. And I replaced it with, I forget what the number is, but it's like the 21-inch octagonal kiln, but it's only two sections deep. So I have the width if I want to make something longer. Previously, they only made the 18-inch guys, and you had to make just nothing bigger than 18 inches. And now they make the 21 ones, but short. And I love that kiln. I fire it a lot.
Do you blaze a whole bunch at one time? Because you fire it so much, do they sit around on your shelf and blaze for a long time?
For a very long time.
That's okay.
Yeah, it doesn't care. Well, if you're smart, you put a drop cloth over it. I'm not always smart, but it's a good idea. It would save me time if I just put a drop cloth over it. And I do have two cats that live in the studio with me. They were walk-ups. I live out in the woods, and I have an indoor cat. But these two guys showed up 2 years running. And they wandered our neighborhood for a while, and no one would claim them, and I just felt bad for them. So we wound up adopting them and getting them neutered and getting them shot. And they live in the studio. They have a cat door in the studio. And if I don't cover things, every now and then I'll come out and somebody will be lying in the glazed letter. Oh, what spy? Don't do that. But he just says, hi, nice to see you. Pardon me. Too tweaked about it, so I try and put things away and spike and see OC find it in my
So do you also have like pots sitting around that are undecorated but glazed for a long period of time?
Mm-hmm.
And it's okay to go back and put these on even after they've sat around and got really, really dry?
Yeah. It just waits for you. And for me, that's also, I mean, the main attraction for my Myolica for me is the brushwork and the ability to use color and the things I can do to transform the piece. But the convenience of it is also that my schedule is pretty chopped up. I teach full time, and spring semester is really lively because I have people applying for jobs, I have people applying for residencies that require letters of recommendation from me, I have people in thesis who are tweaking about getting their show together and they need to talk to me fairly regularly. I also teach undergraduates on a committee at school. So you need to help make decisions that influence your school life, so I do all that. And it's just a circus. So sometimes things really sit for a long time, and I like slipware, but I like slip on leather hard clay, and it's really hard for me to be timely to get to those things. It's advantageous in a time way that I can separate the making from the decorating. And if I walk away from the decorating in the middle and I have a week where I don't get back to it, it's right where I left it. And so aesthetically, I'm not sure that's smart. Aesthetically, you know, it's nice if you have a train of thought and you actually get to put two words together to make a sentence and a couple of sentences to make a paragraph. But if you're doing work on leather hard clay, it just won't wait for you. You just come back and it's all dried out and nasty and you just lost it.